I just hope they'll cover this part until the end. And hello, Rao. We're back at Perform 2018, Diamond Choice in Las Vegas. It's Tuesday night, and I'm here with Rao, who came by, saw one of our SoundTube looking people. He said, how do I get one of those? So he stepped in the channel. Hello, Rao. Nice to meet you.
Something should inspire you to say something or do something, right?
Yes, exactly. Sounds good. Let's see, you have very interesting. Very interesting story, because most of the times, people see performance degradations and they know there's a problem.
Yes.
You have an opposite situation. Yes. Explain this to me.
So, I've been a performance engineer for the last 18 years, by passion, by profession, and so came across a very interesting performance, I would say a problem, because everybody, like you said, Google Dynatrace conference or any APM looks for performance degradation and how to solve the problem. But when I had the performance dashboard up and running in a production command center, one fine day the SOC was, all the guys were there and watching the dashboard, and the performance baseline was around 2 and 3 seconds.
Yeah.
And suddenly, not bad for.
It's not Google, but it's not bad. Right?
It's not bad either. So one day, we had no response time. So it just dropped down. It dropped to a few hundreds of milliseconds. So this was very interesting. The guy said, we are running really fast, being a Dynatrace guy and a performance engineer, like I said, by passion and profession, it sounded to be too good to be true.
Yeah, he said it got down
to 100 milliseconds, between 2.5 to 3 seconds.
You've probably seen this as well. The transaction going from 3 seconds, normal, down to about 100 milliseconds.
Yeah.
What do you think?
In a production system. In a production system on a normal day.
Your first reaction, right, as a long-term, no professional leader, we just had a wonderful performance improvement, right?
Something started here and
there.
Something that used to take time is no longer taking time. That's 404 too fast.
I'm a big fan of this, so I will not miss too much, but I've been following you for a long time. Close to 40
getting close. That would be my first
and
bet.
There are no errors. Actually, there are no errors.
Well, could be swallowing the exception somewhere in the stack.
Then it is pretty catching up. But what happened is, you see, when you build dashboards, people are pretty much interested in the response time. So you build dashboards and the response time. And then there's a little bit of what you call request throughput, but not all requests are captured all the time. What happens in Dynatrace is with the business transactions. So people are interested in putting in dashboards only their business transactions. So the cash flow is happening, receipts are happening, sales are happening, users are happy, user experience is happy, everything is nice.
Or it looks nice.
They are normal. I would say nice, different. Nice is always perspective. Something good for me, not good for.
Yeah.
But they are all normal. No really sensitive. Okay. But only the response thing, only from that second to 100 milliseconds. It was a big one. Actually, I was
it's huge.
It's huge. I was supposed to give a presentation that I was reading it, so I have the people's story. So, it's that. Then, something definitely is weird. So, we started digging. We went into the UEM. And we found out there were a couple of IPs, not a couple, probably several hundred IPs, only doing the small 1x1 JIF, and they're only doing it. They're just trying to only hit that.
So it was skewing the numbers.
Exactly.
Because some functional issue that was only grabbing this 1x1,
like a beacon
GIF or something.
Somebody deliberately playing something on the website, only trying to activate 1x1 GIFs, and they have hundreds of hits.
That actually doesn't know to be labeled the same as the regular request.
Yeah, they're not regular requests. Because if somebody hits the home page, it will load all of them, and it will take 2 to 3 seconds. But somebody will be going to access only the 1x1 JIF, the response will be just running into the system.
The greater transaction gets skewed because it looks now. Okay. It's like, it's super
right. So the average response saying, well, actually got completely skewed and we are performing 100 milliseconds.
Not going to keep my own because I'm not a bird. But I said something something that used to work, that took time, stopped working, like a 404, well, they're not calling the whole page. It's not a 404. You're right.
No errors. There's no 404.
It's a valid
HTTP. Yes. And that's what, that is why we like it. See, that was a really, very, very interesting case. I wanted to share it with you.
No, that's cool.
But I've given performance in the office for 2 decades.
So
this was something that I went to the Knox school, the competition center. They said it's not even putting a threshold of denial of service to actually alert their message.
Right.
So they didn't cancel it. So we told them, yeah, because it's not that high. But
so
it is high enough.
Not frequent enough to actually, and probably not, depending on the DDoS, probably not coming from the same location.
Exactly, not coming from the same IP. So that was really, really. They could not block a certain IP because it's time to release them. So that was really, really weird. But at the end of the day, what they did is they instantly renamed that one by one thing to something else and then it stopped because there's no way you can start on the IP. It's so random. But the interesting thing there is if you put that, if the response is too good to be true, yes, it is wrong.
It's not true.
It's a good picture. It's not true. And the interesting part about that is you're finding not necessarily a possible attack based on a decrease in response to not because the network police got picked off. So I was recently talking to we were talking to Harold from and we were talking about some of the IoT stuff. So we have an IoT agent. And if you recall, a little over a year ago, there was an attack, a DDoS attack. Right now, if we didn't have Dynatrace monitors for IoT at that time, but if people had, one of the characteristics people were doing this afterward was if you were analyzing, you know, this is still a
program,
the memory consumption used by those programs in the web, as this update occurred and this malware got injected, so we knew what the memory size was supposed to be, and the memory size of these IoT devices, and we see weaknesses that we don't have any weaknesses. So sometimes it's not always the obvious metric that's going to capture the time. So like a decrease in response to 2 or 3 back at the but you need to be investigated, which is like.
And even if people give no alerts, no exceptions, no errors, nothing to if it was not high enough for the DDoS to trigger,
right.
The network security could not catch because it's coming from multiple IPs. Again, so that was a very, very classic example of how a performance engineer goes through, not like an IO performance engineer like you, and I'm sharing this story.
No, I'm thinking you could also alert on total page size.
That was a,
like if it falls on a trend, like if you're running in the test mode, you could set, you could look at the trend for the total page size. Depends on that because some pages naturally have high payload, low payload, depending on what they do. Catalogs, images, media, whatever.
Since you're accessing only the JIT, it's not even a page. So you want to page because you won't get that.
You can think that, but I have to check it out with my colleagues.
Yeah,
I believe.
Oh,
yeah.
Excellent.
You
got a sound
here. So, by the way, what you asked was before you came back,
I'm finally starting the list. You're at the top of the list to win our prize. You know what our prize is?
So, I would, but I still want to run water. Clear.
Then you could give it away to a colleague who would appreciate it.
No, Dynatrace UFO that we are trying to send will have limitation on hardware because of the enterprise security, but I want it as a part of the company. But if I win this, I'm going to take it home and build my own app. So I don't want to give it away to a colleague. Because I've already given it to a company, not a colleague.
So here's the other thing I wanted to say about this app. I have to double check with a colleague. But I know Dynatrace, if you all of a sudden drop off the traffic, if you need to send it to the request app, we're going to run. I also believe that the 5% analyzer will have a certain increase in traffic of a single request. So since it's that GIF, it's that GIF
file.
I think Dynatrace will have to flag that for you as opposed to
the 5% I'm noticing it's
right. My throughput on
the same resource. So right. This is not our normal traffic for the time.
And that is exactly what I'm hoping when people are going to sign up for this. AI enablement, that's what I'm hoping to capture and put it out of the way. Anyways, going for monitoring, I use it or rather enable the security, enable the testing. So, Dynamics has a lot more than performance.
And tomorrow, there's going to be some announcements about some AI and IT programs.
Very excited to hear
about it. You too. I've only heard this. So, I don't know if you know it, then.
It's a teaser, not a leak.
Awesome.
So, it's really nice meeting you, Mark.
How are you finding the rest of the great, pretty favorite set of concepts?
The ecosystem that they have built, back in the early 2000s or also mid 2000s, part of the business of the team, they built a tool called Jensen. You can use Jensen in open source. And by putting it in the first time it was exposed, so we built a tool that can do that and it could replay the JVM, and this was a decade back. It could replay the entire JVM or whatever that is. Still there, and the source code is not there, it is there. At that time, the biggest challenge that we want is, can we replay the entire IP? That was a very complex thing, if you can imagine, almost 30, 40 years back, that's an extremely difficult task where multi-core even not even there. Performance was there, it's very difficult for them to do, because you don't have enough people for everything to do all that.
I look forward for the echo and
test that thing out.
Yeah.
No, you don't have to do it now.
Yeah, but I definitely look forward for the echo and UFO, because that is something that I really want to play and probably.
You think you're going to. Yes.
It's like Vegas, you know.
Yes. So that I can present it back to you again, what I did with it next year.
Yeah, that'd be cool. There's a lot of different things you can do. You know what James Paul did? Do you use a UFO as a. Your home studio when you're on air, recording or not?
On air light?
Yeah.
You're going to use the entire a smart device.
I just signed up for a new home, so that'll be a
thing
to automate
my entire
home and
give it.
So
you
need a minute.
Just
it works with home security, not enterprise, so they can put it at home. I've asked passwords about it. Thank you. Thank you.
And enjoy the rest of the show.
Sure.
Ryan? Yes. Ooh, you know what? I'm not simulcasting.
You're not?
Oh. I unplugged myself before. I'm doing bike.
I'm not doing this up.
Anyway, I think we'll take another little break. How much you are doing here? Oh, because it's picking up the live.
No. Dude, how is that?
Because it's coming, it's taking this stuff.
Off of the headphones?
Off of the speaker here. The thing. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna stop that.
It's fine.
It's weird.
But it's fine.
No,
it's getting it off the alpha.
I think it's just saying it is.
But
because the alpha's not plugged in.
But how is it being responsive then?
Because it has a built-in mic. I think it's just coming from the built-in mic at this point.
Anyway.
Alright, enough of the meta.
This is the because we end up